Hello everybody, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Software Testing by MKT. In this video, we are going to talk about a very important topic from interview point of view if you are applying for software testing role, that is severity and priority. So let's get started. So before I tell you in depth about severity and priority, let me tell you when this terms severity and priority comes into the picture. So when tester is testing some software and he is getting some defect, he is getting some bug, and he is raising the bug in the defect tracking tool. Let's say Jira. When our tester is raising some defect, that time when you are raising some defect, when you are raising some bug, you need to give priority and severity of that bug. In the sense, when you are raising any bug, it will only ask you, there will be a component, it will only ask you what is the severity, what is the priority. Now let's talk about what you mean by severity. So, impact of the bug or defect on the customer business workflow, that is called as severity. That means if you are raising any bug, if its impact is more, then it will comes under high severity bug. If whatever the bug you have raised, if its impact on the customer business workflow is less, that time the severity of that bug will be low. Now let's talk about what do you mean by priority. If you are raising any bug for any application, how soon you want developer to fix that bug, that is called as priority. And also importance given to the bug to fix it. Importance given to the bug to fix it, that is called as priority. Suppose you have raised a bug and its priority is high. That means you are trying to convince to the development team that we want you guys to fix it on priority. We want you guys to fix it first, then proceed to the other bugs which are low priority. So this is just the definition of severity and priority. Now let's talk about what are the types of severity we have. So talking about the types of severity, we have four types of severity, which is nothing but blocker, critical, major and minor. When you are raising any bug, if you are telling that this particular bug is a blocker severity, indirectly you are trying to tell that impact of this bug on the customer business workflow, it is a blocker. Means if we won't fix this bug, customer won't be able to proceed further. It is a blocker for him. Now let me tell you an example. When you will say any bug severity is blocker, you are trying to log into the application, you are trying to log in with your username and password, but it is not allowing you to proceed to the home page. It is telling internal server error, or it is telling password doesn't match, or it, when you are trying to log in, it is taking you to some blank page. It is completely blocked. What you will do? You will not be able to proceed to the next step. Your full functionality itself is blocked. That time when you are raising any bug, your severity should be blocker. Now let's talk about what do you mean by critical severity bug. When we are telling the bug which is raised is critical severity, it means, guys, if any company is developing some software, there will be a certain purpose which it performs. Like we have today Uber and Ola. What is the major functionality of it? We book the Ola cab comes, we get inside, it drop us to the place where we want it. What is the main functionality of Amazon? We search something, we like it, we do the payment, and it gets delivered to our home. This is the main functionality. Suppose if you are raising a bug and you are telling it's a critical severity bug, you are indirectly telling that main functionality of the application itself is not working. Suppose you are working in some bank application where you have sent 10,000 rupees to some another account. When you log into that particular account, you check the balance, it is showing only 5,000. The basic functionality itself is not working. You have sent 10,000 to some B account, and when you are checking that balance, it is showing just 5,000. Basic functionality itself is not working. So it's a critical bug severity. I am not blocked, but it is critical bug which we need to fix it. Because of this bug, customer business workflow has completely broken. They are not able to proceed with their business. That is called as critical severity bug. Now let's talk about what do you mean by major severity bug. When you say it is a major severity bug, that means you have got a bug, but you don't know how it is impacting the customer business workflow. functionality and all, everything is working, but there is some defect because of which you are not able to understand how it is impacting the customer business workflow. Suppose example of major severity bug is you are trying to send a mail, you have composed the mail, you have clicked on the send button. The moment you click on send button, nothing is displaying. When you're going to the send box and checking the mail, you are saying that mail is already sent. But when you had clicked on the send button, that time you didn't get any pop-up or message that message is being sent or message is sending. Second example, when you're trying to book a Ola cab or Uber cab, you have booked it, but you didn't get any message from Uber team that your driver is waiting. You didn't get any message. Your functionality is working, but how you got to know that your Uber had got booked? You got to know that because when he arrived it, he only called me. My functionality is working, but I didn't receive any message. So I don't know how it is impacting the customer business workflow. That is called as major severity bug. Now let's talk about what do you mean by minor severity bug. Minor severity bug is you are 100% sure that this particular bug, my minor severity bug, is not at all impacting my customer business workflow. Minor severity bugs usually will be like look and feel of an application and some spelling mistakes or alignment issues. Those and all bugs comes under the category of minor severity bugs. Example, you are trying to log in the application in the Chrome browser also, in the Mozilla browser also. When you are checking your application in Mozilla browser, you are feeling that look and feel of an application is somewhat different when compared to the Chrome browser. So you raise a bug stating that it is a minor severity bug. Or when you are trying to log in with your application and username text field and your password name text field, this alignment issue you observe, they are not aligned with each other. They are like this. Alignment issue you are facing, it is not going to impact my customer business workflow. Customer business workflow will work, but it will come under minor severity bug. Now let's talk about what are the various types of priority we have. So when it comes to priority, we have P0, P1, P2. Always remember, different company will have different standard. P0 will always be having the high priority, P1 will be having little low priority, P2 will be having little low priority. It is like this. P0 will be having high priority. Similarly here also, blocker is having high. So what do you mean by P0 priority bug? When you raise any bug and you say that it is P0 category bug, that means this is the bug which developer has to fix immediately. When you raise any bug, when you say that it belongs to the P1 category bug, you mean that developer has to fix it at least in the coming builds. And when you say that it is a P2 category bug, P2 priority bug, you say that developer can fix it in the upcoming releases. There is no hard and fast rule that you should fix the bug immediately, but you can fix it in the coming releases, maybe in the second release or maybe into the next to next releases. So this is all about severity and priority. Always remember, it is the QA who will decide what will be the priority and what will be the severity of any bug. It will be the tester who will decide the priority and severity of any bug. In some of the companies, product manager or developer can change the priority of any bug which is raised by the testers. Always remember this. So there is one famous question which you can expect in any of the interview. They can ask you to give an example for high priority and high severity bug, or they can ask you what is the example of low severity and high priority bug. They can ask you what is the example of high severity and low priority bug, or they can also ask you to give an example for low severity and low priority bug. So example of high severity and high priority bugs are, let's say you are logging into the application and when you are trying to log in, it is taking to the blank page. It is a blocker. Login itself is not working. So when you are raising a bug, you should tell that it is a blocker. It is a blocker severity. And what will be the priority? Priority will be my P0. You want developer to fix it immediately. So this is one example. Now we are going to talk about example for high severity and low priority. Talking about high severity and low priority, suppose in your application there is a link called as About Us. When you're trying to click on it, it is going to the blank page. So it is a blocker for me, which is my high severity, but it is not that priority to fix it. So I will give it as a P2, that we can fix it in the upcoming releases. Since it is not going to impact my customer business workflow, I don't want my developer to spend most of their time in that. That time they can utilize it somewhere else. Now let's talk about an example for high priority and low severity. Let's say you have logged in your application. Your application name is abc.com. When you have logged in into your application, you can see here homepage. Link will be there, right? So homepage, about us, and multiple major tabs are present. You see that homepage, the spelling of home is written something like, spelling mistake is there, but it is not affecting my customer business workflow. But since if any user is logging into your application, the first thing they will see is this page. So it is of my minor severity, but high priority, my P0. Why? Because it is not going to affect my customer business workflow. So it will come under my minor severity bug. But since most of my customers are, when they will log into the application, they will see this page. So from the customer business point of view, from company point of view, spelling should not look odd. Spelling mistakes should not be there in your application when customer is logging for the first time. So for that sake, your priority will be P0 to fix it. Now let's talk about an example for my low severity and low priority. Suppose you are having an application in which there are multiple major tabs are present, like home page, about us page, contact us page. So when user is clicking on the contact us page, it is written that phone number and their email ID. The spelling of email ID is wrong. See, as a QA, I will raise a bug for that. When you are raising a bug, since it is not going to affect my customer business workflow at all, it will come under my minor severity bug. And since it is, navigation is very inside, means how many people will go inside my contact us and see the phone number and email ID, and they can observe that email ID spelling is wrong? Very less. So I will give the severity of the bug is minor, and also I will give the priority to fix this bug is P2. I don't want my developer to waste their time in fixing this. They can fix this in the upcoming releases. So I will assign them as a P2 priority bug. So I hope this video was useful to you guys. If yes, please give a thumbs up to this video, subscribe to my channel Software Testing by MKT, and please share this video with your needy friends.